They are just running around, they don't know what the fuck they would want to do. Can we take this vehicle, beat them like this? Oh! We have captured High Chief and Mielus quest, Deruap and three others during the siege of Olavinlinna. Welcome back to Crusader Kings 3. My name is Kroni and we have jumped a little bit into the future. My last recorded episode was corrupted. It had very weird audio and frame issues, so I had to scrap it. So now I'm planning to do a small recap what happened in that episode. It was only 20 minutes, so it's not that far in the future. So here we are. As you can see, it has changed a bit. There is Uppland now here in the Dutch county of Finland. Well, that is because High Chief Talvikki attacked Savo. They claimed Pielinen for themselves. They are still fighting over it. And Uppland saw their opportunity and they attacked Finland and claimed this county of Finland here. I was trying to be fast when they went into war. I tried to attack Finland and gain myself here, but I was defeated by the Uppland army, so I lost my claim there. And now Uppland has made the things a bit more harder for us, since now we have to fight him in order to make Finland whole again. And yes, about Chief Mielus, well, Mielus is pretty much the same. He gained a river in one event. Also, he got wounded because of accident with a horse. Otherwise, he is still temperate, diligent and deceitful man and an athletic lunatic. Her wife is Sifte's Pieta still, and I have managed to turn Pieta into Suomen usko, so that's why we are now currently having 100 opinion of, or she is having 100 opinion of me. Also, my heir is soon of age. He is Lallihämäläinen, 15 years old. So yeah, that is pretty much what happened in the last episode that you were not able to see. And now my thinking is that am I going to attack the Savo Duchy first, or am I trying to take this part here first? I'm just afraid if I go here, then I will most likely get attacked by Uppland at some point, because they want the whole Duchy at some point. So I think my safer bet would be to go into Savo and conquer this Duchy here, but I have to think how I'm going to do it, because Finland is currently attacking it and they are actually winning the war. He has ally of Visby, ally from Visby called Jarl Stein, and he has his own army here, 600, so they have 1200 soldiers currently, a bit more, 1400 soldiers almost, against 500 of Olavinlinna. So if I go war with Savo, I would have to beat all the three armies if I want to take whole Duchy. So we have a bit of money in the coffers. Also, one problem is that I have currently 4 out of 5 champions, so I need one more champions when I'm able to get. Most likely my son will become one when he is of age. He has pretty average personal combat skill, so I'm not worried about that. He is pretty good in diplomacy at the moment, and that is good because in the last episode I actually lost my chancellor. Now my current chancellor is pretty terrible, so I could replace him with my son. Also, I have 2 daughters now, Emmi Hämäläinen and Elisabeth Hämäläinen. I was a bit worried. Emmi is pretty okay, but look at Elisabeth. She is very, very small and scary looking child. Let's hope she will grow to be a bit more beautiful person in the future. Let's unpause the game and see what is going to happen here at the Savo. Or should I just declare the war and try to beat them all? Oh yeah, I cannot do a Duchy. Well, I could take Olavinlinna for now. I could at least do that. Yes, he is having a lot less soldiers than me. We shall go to war. It is time that we fight. Raise all armies. Let's go, let's attack him. Chieftain Ahma of Käkisalmi joined Nylander conquest chiefdom of Olavinlinna. So now we are fighting Käkisalmi as well. Well, they don't have that many troops anyway, so I think we are fine there. Let's march. We have to also be careful of these because they are hostile armies since we are fighting at them. Well, let's beat them first then. I don't remember if we have talked about the combat in this game in detail. I can do a fast recap about that as well. Here is our rolls. This happens every 3 days. At this round we roll a 13, he roll a 2, so we won the roll. And here is battle advantage. This is how the higher the advantage, the better we are doing damage wise. And if we have positive advantage, then we won that round pretty much. Like here you can see that we rolled 48, he rolled 37, so our advantage was 11. And that increased our damage by 22%. We are unformed pagan, that gives us plus 10. He is also same, so that is same as mine. He is defending in Taiga Forest. Because of our religion, he gets plus 4 bonus on that. Battle roll was 13, he rolled plus 2. And he has pretty good commander with the plus 16 bonus, but we have plus 20, so we have even more better. Also we both are, our religion gives us both this Sanctify of Nature, it's plus 5 when we are fighting the forest. Here we can see the stages, the first one is maneuver, we passed that. So now we are at the early battle phase, and that means that we cannot retreat yet. And if we are destroyed, we will lose whole our army, we cannot regroup anymore. The next phase is a late battle phase, then we can retreat if we right-click somewhere on the map. Also, if we lose there, we don't lose whole of our army. And the last one is aftermath, that is where we slay those that are left behind in the battlefield. Here we can see we have routed casualties 37, that means it is casualties that will be back to us after the battle, they are run away. There is also fatality to casualties, that means they are dead. He has 63, so we have less routed casualties right now. We have 4 champions, he has 3 champions. So let's get the rolls, we lost few rolls again here. Oh, now we are losing very badly. We are getting bad rolls. He is rolling 50, I'm rolling 8. But lucky we have the number advantage, so we won. Now we are pursuing him and he is retreating. And here it says that the winning side is cutting down the remaining losing soldiers. So we won this, but we took a bit of beating here. And he is going there. I have to be careful here. Let's move a bit further, let's see where they are going. We go here now. And we try to go siege the high chiefdom of Savo here. Aka Olavinlinna. So we get the war score at least on our name. That will give us a big boost. They are going into the sea for some reason. We shall siege here. Let's check out the siege window fast. Here is the progress of the siege. When you gain 200, you win the siege. Now we have 5.2. We are making 1 per day of siege progress. And there is 6 months left at this speed until it's over. Here is the siege event window. Every 20 days something happens. It might destroy the supplies that are fully stocked right now. Or the garrisons might take damage or something. Current it's normal because we just started. And their walls are intact. If we have siege weapon, we could breach the wall and then we can assault the fort. But we cannot do that right now. Also, this event might also do something for us that we lose something or some progress. So, it can happen, it can affect both sides of the fight. But let's see what happens here. Now it's just the worst roll. Stalemate, so neither of us gained anything or lost anything. They are going to Porvo, so I have to go defend there. My son has become of age. With his coming of age, my tradition of Lalli is at an end. Can come to truly understand it. He has shown great aptitude both in battle tactics and the management of armies. He will make a fine commander one day, I'm sure. They grow so fast. He has gained skilled tactician, plus 6 martial and more experience, and Loki's decision that is supply duration plus 100. Pretty nice. Now we have make him my chancellor. Also, I think he will become one of my champions, yeah. Well, let's do. They are not attacking Porvo. Good, good. We can cease in peace here. Let's check how it is going. Stalemate all the time, so we are not getting boost or losing anything. Crewmate rule, Emmy Havala has increased her intrigue by 2. Let's see the next roll here. Stalemate, we are very unlucky. We are very unlucky indeed. We are not getting anything used to us. It's 4 months until the siege is over. I don't know what they are doing. Maybe he is going to unseize that one. That would be good. That would be pretty good. Okay, they got disease outbreak. So now the sickness is spreading. Daily siege process plus 10%. So now we are making 1.1 per day. So not that big boost, but at least something. And another stalemate. Neighbor's war resolved. Your neighbor high siege the Staviki won against your other neighbor high siege the Mielus in the Finnish conquest of Siegedom of Pielinen. So Ola Savo is now smaller and Finland is growing. Damn. That was not what I wanted. Well, at least it won't as affect our taking of Olavinlinna. So the siege should be over pretty soon. 21 days and sickness is spreading. Now it is plus 20%. They are just running around. They don't know what the fuck they would want to do. When we take this, we go beat them. Like this. Let's... Oh. We have captured High Siftime Mielus quest Deruap and 3 others during the siege of Olavinlinna. And the siege is won. We now control Olavinlinna. We got 15 gold for occupying Olavinlinna. And we actually got 100% because we are occupying all his land. He only has Olavinlinna now because he lost Pielinen. Also we got plus 50% because we captured his heir. And these are other things you can, this is ticking war score. If you're holding the object, it ticks every month. And this one is from the battles. We didn't fight any battles against him, but we fought against the Finland, so we didn't gain there any progress. Well, now we can enforce demands. And we are going to gain his lands, and he is pretty much defeated from the game. I gain 75 fame and 75 prestige. To the loathsome Siftime Mielus, may your years be short and miserable. You are a much greater foe than I imagine. In order to put an end to this plot, I will comply with your demands. Now we have gained Olavinlinna for ourselves. And we can disband our armies. So yeah, now we at least grew a bit. Let's check out the control here. It's 0. So we might want to put our morsel there to get the control back up. Since when the control is low, we lose 99% taxes and 49% of their levies. So big penalties when control is low. Yes, that is good. Now we have at least grown a bit bigger. Lalli has no spouse. Let's see if we could get any good alliances. County of Bihar. Where is County of Bihar? It is in Bulgaria. There is only Bulgarian women for my son, I see. Last time I was trying to make alliances as well, there was only Bulgarian people. What I was doing? I was doing this one. Ipek Akhasir would have been that lady there. 30 years old, pretty old. Alpino. There's Zach. Potential alliance of County of... Well, I'm not going to pronounce that. It is also... Is it here? No, it's here in... above Transylvania, so it's... It is as bad choice as the other one. There is no child here. Well, there is Irene. Oh, she is betrothed already. What about you? You have only 8 years old. Tuota... Sweden, Kingdom of Sweden has been made. I can see now. He is now King Björn Ironside of Sweden. She has 4 years old daughter. Should I make alliance with Sweden for now? Child of concubine. If we were... betrothed, would we gain an alliance? We would gain an alliance, but he will not accept it. Minus 120%. Different weight. King Björn is marrying down and many other penalties. How about here? I think that is the same problem. He has son and daughter. Well, too young. Käkisalmi, well, I'm not interested. Well, let's just take some... We don't get any alliances anyway, so... where is Temes? Well, yeah. Here we are. Near Bulgaria again. So let's just check something that is good. Is there anyone of my religion? Police... There is one Suomen usko. 24 years old Nulsuava. Wandering godless Ravener. 10, 10, 16, 10, 11. Pretty good stats. Or 24 years old Rava. She is also Suomen usko. Her culture is Meskhara. Trusting, chaste and patient. 7, 10, 11, 11, 10. Or Noaidi Lees of Osel, 16, 16, Estonian, Suomen usko, diplomacy, stewardship, intrigue. Trusting, chaste, patient, cynical, greedy, patient, fretful, brave, and arbiter, quick. Well, maybe we go with this one. Yes, we can... No, she gets 600, we lose... Lally loses 100 prestige, but it's okay for now. We shall do it, we shall take this quick woman. Maybe our children will become quick. Yes, we are fixing the low control. That is fine. We can create Duchy of Savo. I'm not sure if I want to do it yet. We can run some Deruap Kodar or take a concubine. And Lally Hamalen can marry. Well, we did that already. Let's check this one. Yes, let's do that. We get 10 golds. 10 gold. It's fine. Greetings, chieftain Mielos of Nyland. I accept your marriage proposal. Your son and heir Lally and my acquaintance Lise will be joined in holy matrimony. May Uk grant them long life and many children. Excellent. Now they are married. Lally has now wife. And maybe they will get children soon. Good. Let's unpause and see what is going to happen next. A prisoner is released. Greetings, chieftain Mielson. I accept your ransom offer and hope to someday show you the same hospitality. Fine. I'm still thinking to attack the Duchy of Finland. We are pretty good shape soldier-wise. 1590 soldiers, so we are not doing that. He is too powerful with that alliance he has now. Oh, she has now. And it is because of Valtteri Korhonen. Her future husband. What the heck, is it too far away to interact? It is there. So, you are allied with the Visp. Visp is here. Wow, that is pretty cool portrait. Yes. Well, that is my current situation in Crusader Kings 3. At least now Nyland is a bit bigger. Well, how about you? You don't have any alliances. Should I just attack you? We could just easily eat you and we could gain a bit more space for us. Yes, why not? You don't have any alliances. We can take you out pretty quickly. Let's do that and then we are going to end this episode. Go there, my friends. Go Mars. My wound has healed. You lost the trade wounded. Good, good. But my question is, no, we are not scarred. Fine, that is pretty nice. I don't know if he is even going to raise his armies, because he will be lose. He will lose them right away. So we can seize down. Oh, he did it. And we reach them in time. It's sick. 16 days and 0 days. Yes, we can beat them. No, that is a lie. Why it says 0? Oh, 11 days, 1 day. Yeah, so we shall stay here and seize. They ran away. Let's seize down this. Siege of Viipuri. It should not take much longer. They lost some food, so we gain one time increase of siege process by 10%. Pretty nice. I think we can just boost plus 4, so this would go a bit faster, since I'm not worried about his armies. Not worried at all about his army, and we can seize this pretty fast. Good. And now shall we seize this next part, and I think that is enough. We got 3 gold coin for that. I think he is going to march Porvo, but we can seize much faster than him, so there is no worry, we don't need to defend. When we get this, we get 100% war score and it's over. Because we control all of his land. Then we gain control of Viipuri for ourselves. Pretty nice. Oh, they can even seize because they are too small than my garrison. And it's done. We have 100% war score and we even took Ahma's son Päivio as a prisoner. Oh, don't go there. You shall go there and we shall end this battle. Enforce demands and enforce demands. Greetings, Chieftain Mielus of Nyland. May your years be short and miserable. You are at much greater fault than I imagine. In order to put end to this bloodshed, I will comply with your demands. We gain 75 fame. How much until we are next level of fame? We still need 230 pretty much. But now we gain control of Viipuri. Or did we? We took this part. Yeah, we took Käkisalmi, not Viipuri. Yeah, yeah, my mistake. Okay, let's end the episode here. Oh, damn, we got 75 taxes because our steward has such a good stewardship skill. And my concubine Maria is now pregnant. So many things happening. Well, thank you for watching. See you next time when I'm doing another episode of Crusader Kings 3. Crony out, stay healthy and stay safe. Bye!